Hello, what's up everybody? It is your sister at heart. My name is Princess Sanja and I am here with the Unisa video. If you're coming for the first time, please do press subscribe button down below. And if you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much for coming through. Today's video, as you can see in the title, we are actually going to be talking about the ways that you can use to study alone, especially if you are in a long distance learning like us, the Unisa students. I am going to actually give you the do's and the don'ts and the steps as to what to do in order to study effectively for your examination. So without wasting any more of your time, let's just go straight to the video. So in this video, what I'm going to be doing, I'm going to be giving you 10 steps or 10 steps to actually follow in order to study effectively, especially if you're studying for examinations alone. Okay, this works like magic. I'm going to tell you the first thing. The first thing that you need to make sure is that you eat. Okay, you need to eat. But then in eating also, you don't want to eat too much before you start studying, because you're going to feel sleepy and you are not going to be able to stay attentive to your books. So make sure that when you're eating, you eat at least an hour before you start, or 30 minutes before you start with your preparation or your studying. And also when you are eating, do not eat heavy meals. Try to eat small amount of meal and keep your food. And then every time when, like maybe after studying, then you can continue eating your food. I don't know if it makes sense. So it depends how much time you want to be spending on your studying, but make sure that you do not overeat or you do not undereat when you are going to study, because you need to be undistracted. But have a drink, not alcohol, definitely. Have something to drink next to you that you're going to be sipping on, you know, while you are studying. Most especially water, but if you want other things, it's fine. But you have to be hydrated as possible as you can. Number three is the anxiety. I know that exams can sometimes be very stressful, but I've noticed something that we actually usually get anxiety, talking about myself. I get anxiety and stress when I know that I am really not prepared. You know, when I know that I don't have a plan, when you don't have a plan as to how you're going to study and if the time that you have allocated for yourself is enough, you get anxiety, you get stressed, you panic. So if you want to avoid anxiety, make sure that you have a plan. You know that on this day, I'm not going anywhere. I'm going to be with my books. Okay. At this particular time of the day, I'm going to be studying. Usually for me, it used to help me to study during the night. I can like be able to do other things during the day, maybe get a nap, but I know that at night I'll be definitely be able to study, because according to my environment was very peaceful at night when my family members are sleeping, because I'm a mom as well, so it's become very noisy sometimes at home. So you have to look at your lifestyle, at your life, I mean, which time is perfect for you. Maybe you're working during the day, at night you obviously are tired, so you have to find a time that is suitable for you in order to study early. Also have to start early, because the more time you have to start early, the more preparation you can do up to your satisfaction. So another thing that we need to focus on, once that you have eaten, you are hydrated, you have dealt with anxiety because there's a plan in hand, you need to make sure that you rest. Like I said, some of us are working, and some of us, we don't just work sitting, we work physically. Sometimes we get tired. Even the things that you wear, the kind of jobs where you are working mentally, like you need your brain, maybe sitting almost the whole day, it is also exhausting. Even driving for a long time also is exhausting, it's tiring. So you need to be well rested. You cannot, I don't want to lie to you, you will not be able to study when you are tired. You will not. It will not be effective. Maybe you can cram, but you will not be able to fully study effectively when you are tired. So make sure that you are well rested. Don't start doing heavy chores at home when it's during the times where you need to be studying for exams. Do something light. Leave it to other people if you leave it to other people, or just postpone it for next time or after you have finished your studying, if it's something that it's for you. But it is very important to make sure that you are well rested so that you can be able to comprehend and understand and study, you know, with an understanding. If you need help, find help. Maybe you're a full-time mom. If there's somebody you can send the child to, you can do that. If there's a daycare maybe that you can pay for just for those particular days, because daycares actually do provide services where you pay for a day. If you do afford, take your child. If you have relatives, you do that as well. But it is very important to make sure that you have help. During this time, you honestly do need help. When you do not have help, you need to make sure that you find ways to make sure that you are rested. Otherwise, you will not be able to achieve the highest that you can possibly can do with your abilities in terms of writing your examinations. Another thing that I find effective is music. So it is up to you how you're going to use music in the middle of your studying. Some people find studying while listening to music is very effective. So if you have never tried it, I'd suggest that you do try it maybe for like 30 minutes of studying and see how it's going. You can find maybe you're also one of those people who are very much, you know, productive when they are studying with music on. But then if it is not working, it's fine. You can always use music as something to break from. You know, I usually advise that when you study, what you do, you take your books, right? Whatever book that you are studying from, your study guide, whatever that you're using, you read for 10 minutes. And when you read for 10 minutes, you take a 5-minute break in between. So in that 5-minute break, maybe that's when you can now involve your music. You can listen to your favorite music just so your mind stay entertained and relaxed, not to overdo it. You can then use the music in that case. But music comes very handy because music produces this particular hormone. I'm going to write it up here because I've forgotten what it's called. There's a particular hormone of happiness that it produces when you are listening to music. So it's kind of like it's going to help you and push you into being able to study all the way through. So as I was talking about reading, so how do you read? What I would suggest to you is that if you're reading the content for the first time, first read for the first time. Maybe let's read one page. You read the whole page, just reading through without doing anything. And then you read that page again with your notepad and the pen on the side. Now you are not only reading, but you are reading and summarizing what you are reading. And what I normally do that helps me a lot is that I actually even change the phrasing that will suit my speaking, because we all know that we don't speak the same. There are words you're going to come across in the book that are not your daily words to use and which you might end up forgetting. So if you don't want to cram but you want to understand your content, it's better you read through the book and you summarize it in your own paraphrasing. You paraphrase the sentences and the phrases according to the way you usually speak in a way that you will be able to remember. I don't know if it makes sense like that. So when you will also need a dictionary during this phase, because when you come across a word that you're not familiar with from the book, you will then need to check it up and see what other synonyms that are much familiar to you that you can use of the word. Of course, there are words a word of a subject, because each and every subject has its own vocabulary. There are words you will not be able to, you know, to divert and change into other synonyms. You will be forced to memorize them for the sake of marks and stuff, where you have to state what they are. So you have to be careful there. Make sure that the words that needs to be, you know, said in order for you to get the marks according to the subject, you know them, the terminology they call it. But any other explanations, you need to make sure that you just use the language according to how you use a language, according to how you speak. And obviously, it has to be formal. You know, as much as it is about how you speak, it still has to remain formal because you are writing an academic, you know, assessment. So it needs to be formal as much as it can. You write on your notepad on the side while you are reading and summarizing. And the reason why we are doing that is because you do not need to always go back to your book. Eventually, there will come a time where your examination is much closer. The last days of your exam, of your preparing for your examination, has to be the days of reminding your brain of what you have studied. So you will be looking through your notepad, not the book. Okay? Not the book. So you can understand. I think with this information, you will know for sure how much time you need to dedicate on your book. You know the size of your book, the thickness of your book. You know the type, the number of chapters that you need to cover on your particular module. So knowing that you need to read, if you never read, I'm assuming you've already read it, because maybe you use the same book to actually prepare for your assignments. So you will not need to read it and read it the second time to when you are reading for summarizing. So you can just do the summarizing part from the go. But then you need to make sure that time is very important, which is the point that I was going to, which is time management is very important. Hence is the reason why it is important to start as early as possible, so that you will be able to get some time a little bit later on of your studying for you to be able to then go through what you have been, you know, summarizing and writing and reading and learning. So when you've done summarizing, finding words that you are not familiar with, writing the terminology or whatever that needs to be covered in those chapters for your module, you need to now dedicate some time to read from your notepad or your notebook. You are no longer looking at the book at this time, because if you do that, we know for a fact that when you are not even close into being prepared. You know, like I used to see this all the time. That's when my eyes actually got open. I could come in a venue, in an examination venue, and I'm there with my thick book. And everybody is like having their notes, you know. No one is carrying a book. That's when I realized that there's something wrong that I'm doing. So you don't want to be that kind of a person when you people are like refreshing their brains early in the morning. Maybe if you're writing in the morning, I don't know. And people are like, they're surrounded by, you're surrounded by people who are there reading into their notes, they're discussing, and you're there with your book. It just shouts that I am so not ready, I didn't study. So you don't want to be that person. Okay, so make sure that you do read your notes, and especially when you're going to your examination, a venue. Oh, sorry, we are not doing venues anymore. We are doing online. But those who are doing venues is fine if it applies to them. So before, like on the day, let's say you are writing your exam at 2 afternoon, maybe you are there trying to refresh your mind around 10 a.m. So you don't want to be dealing with the book at that time. You are dealing with your notes, not a book. Okay, now the last step, which is also really important, is to find time before your examination, after you have done all this, to actually test yourself. You need to test your knowledge. You need to test how much work you've done with your studying. Fortunately for us with Unisa, I don't know, I think maybe other also in academic institutions they do this, but with us at Unisa, they usually provide us with our previous papers. I've ever said this in another video. They do actually provide us with previous examination papers. They give you a clue as to into seeing like how they design, you know, an examination paper. And they also give you a clue how they paraphrase the questions and what type of things they ask. So it's easy to, like, you know, after you've studied and covered the content that needs to be covered for your exam, to use your past or your previous examination papers to prepare for your exam. Like, you can, like, act as if they're an actual exam and answer them without going back to your book. And then you can mark yourself and see how much you've got. And wherever where you didn't get the total, you go back and read that until you get it right. So with that strategy, if you are studying alone, you will never go wrong. Thank you so much for staying tuned in. Like I said, if you are coming for the first time, please do press subscribe button down below. If you're returning subscriber, thank you so much for staying tuned in. Also, please do, guys, press the notification bell down below so that you can be able to be notified every time when I upload a new video. So guys, thank you from me to you. All I can say is I'll see you on the flip side. Bye.